Being able to view your events and tasks in a calendar view can help you visualize your due dates and upcoming events. In Notion, calendars can be a powerful database view because it can add visual interest to your pages and show more information. In this video, we'll be covering all you need to know about calendar view as well as some unique tips and tricks. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first go over all of the ways that you can create a calendar in Notion. So if you have an empty Notion page, you can simply type /calendar and it's going to pull up a inline calendar view database. You can click plus new calendar and it's basically going to show up like this. You can title the database and you can also hide the database title if you wish. So the difference between inline and a database is that inline means that you can move this around, you can type things above and below it and kind of reposition it. On the other hand, if you want to create a database page, you can also do that as well. So if we have an empty page here, you would go all the way down here to the three dots and then you can click calendar. And that's going to transform this page into a calendar database page, which means that you can't add anything below or above. But one of the best things about this version is that it's an easier to see layout and also you don't have the fear of accidentally deleting it as this is where the database is stored. Another way to add a calendar is if you already have an existing Notion database that you want to either view in calendar view or if you want to pull something up and then change it into calendar view. So if we go ahead and type /calendar and then we see link existing database, all of these could be viewed in a calendar view. So let's say we click this one and now we can see it in calendar view. So once you have a calendar, the next thing we wanted to show you is the various layout options. So if we go ahead and go to the three dots here and then go to layout, you have the ability to show the calendar as month or as week. So if you want to see your week fully and focus on that week view can be great. Otherwise, month view can also work to see a bigger layout, but it does squish the entries a bit so that it's a little bit harder to see every single entry. Next, let's try adding calendar entries inside. So if we add an item here, for example, call Anne, and then we click out, you can see that we have a entry inside of here. You can also add entries by clicking the new here, but then you'll have to make sure to enter the date like this. And then let's say water plants. Next, let's go over what kind of properties you can add here. So if we go over and open one up, you can see that we first have tags. So we can go ahead and add a tag here called phone call. And then let's say that we also have a checkbox for whether or not it's complete. So once you add all the properties you want, there's a lot more options here. There's also suggestions on what kinds of things you could add. So all of these are unlimited. And then if we go and click out, you'll notice that you don't see anything here. So what you'll have to do is go to the three dots here, go to properties, and then toggle them on so that you can actually see them. And you can also reorder them by dragging it. The next thing is that you can actually wrap the text to a certain extent. So let's take, for example, water plants, for example, and we have flowers, outdoor, porch, and more text here, then you can see that we cannot read the entire title anymore. So if we go ahead and go to the three dots here and then go to layout and you can toggle on wrap page titles, you can see now that we can read a bit more of the text. However, as you can see, two lines is the maximum. So this text here gets cut off. So there is a little bit of a limit in terms of the wrapping. Next, if you wanted to show the time that you're going to do this, we can go ahead and add that. So if we go ahead and click this one open and click the date, you can toggle on include time. And let's say that this is going to be 3 p.m. And then if we click out, you'll see here now that it says 3 p.m. If you wanted to also add a start and end time, you can also do that. So it could be 3 to 4 p.m. like this. But unfortunately, you cannot see the end time inside of the calendar, so you only see the beginning time. Next, let's say that we also have a second date. So if we go ahead and click this one open and add a date, and we can call this date 2, then what happens is that you can actually opt to see the calendar based on date 2 instead of date. So if we go ahead and go to the three dots here, and then we go to the layout, then you can go ahead and go to show calendar by, and then click date two. So then we see this by day two, but then the other one gets disappeared because it doesn't have a date. Another thing you can do is to show the calendar based on either starting on Sunday or starting on Monday. To do that, you'll want to go to your settings. So if we go to the left-hand sidebar and then go to settings and members, and then what we can do is go to language and region. You can toggle on start week on Monday, on or off. Another interesting feature that you can enable inside of your Notion calendar here is that if you go to the three dots here and then go to layout, you can actually show the calendar without weekends. So we can toggle this off to show only a 5-day schedule. Finally, another feature some people might be interested in is having a recurring entry. So let's say that we want to water the plants every Friday. We can go ahead and go to this blue button here plus new template. And then we can do water plants. And then for date, it can be the date when duplicated or time when duplicated if you want to also add the time. So once we have that, what you can do is you go here and then you can click the three dots here and then turn on repeat to be weekly. And then you could set it at a certain time so that whenever that time comes, it's going to show up inside of the calendar. So unfortunately, you cannot set up a recurring event that will already populate the calendar, but in this way you could potentially add something recurring inside of your calendar. The final thing we wanted to talk about is Notion Calendar. So Notion and Notion Calendar are separate but connected apps. So if you wanted to open this calendar database inside of Notion Calendar, you simply have to click open in calendar. We have a very detailed tutorial about Notion Calendar, so we highly recommend you to check it out. But basically what's really cool is that you can combine all of your calendar view databases inside one place and see them all in the same view along with your Google Calendar. So if you haven't checked that already, be sure to try out Notion Calendar as well to use alongside your Notion workspace. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to let us know, and we hope to see you all in the next video.